A lot of people want to remove that published date or author name from their blog post or pages or their homepage on their blog, all right? And that is very frustrating at times. They don't want to display that entire metadata on their blog post. Hi, this is Digital Pratik, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can remove your author name, your post date, and that by on or posted by, whatever it is written on your homepage, on your posts, and on your individual pages. All right, so this is the thing which you want to remove. So it would be something like, depending on your theme, whatever it is written, like for my theme, it's written by, and then the author name, which is myself, and then on, then the month, date, and year. All right, so this is something which people at times don't want to display on the website. So what you can do is, you can actually install and activate one plugin and do a couple of changes to remove this thing, all right? So let me just jump into that. So what you have to do is you have to first install this WP Meta and Date Remover plugin, which is frequently being updated. And if you check out the ratings are also pretty decent enough, all right? It's almost 4.7, 4.5, and it's working well. So I've tried myself as well, and it requires less of some editing and coding stuff. So let's straight away download that. So I'll be putting the link below in the description box, so you don't have to search for it. It's WP Meta and Date Remover. I'll put up the link. You land on this page, click on download, and then you can go ahead and install and activate the plugin. Now, if you don't know how to install and activate the plugin, you can click on this I symbol on the top right corner, and one card will open up. You will have a video if you are not aware about how to install and activate the plugin in WordPress. I assume you already know that and you have installed and activated your plugin. And once you install and activate, you'll have to go into settings and you'll have to go into WP Meta and Date Remover. Once you go there, you'll have this particular page which might have this first option, which is remove from home page, checked or unchecked. If it is not, do check mark it, because what it says is uncheck this if you want to show dates on home page or post list page. Now, I don't want to show my dates on the home page, so I'm checking mark this. Then second is disable PHP removal. Clicking this will disable PHP filter for your dates and other metadata. Search engine will show your dates in snippet. So I don't want to disable a PHP filter right now, and same way I don't want to disable my CSS filter as well. Then fourth is, it's written also read. So let's say what happens when I'm doing this only thing. All right, let's save the changes. Let's go to a different browser and let's refresh the page and let's see if anything is happening over here or not. All right, so nothing is happening on the individual page. Let's go ahead and check our home page if there is any change or not. So on the home page, now see, on the home page, there is nothing. On the home page, there is nothing for me. If I scroll down, there is nothing for me for all the posts. But there is something like buy on. Now, this depends on the theme. If you are on a basic theme, then probably the buy on would also be disappearing. If it is not, don't worry. I'm going to show you in a moment. So on the home page, it's completely different. And if you go into the individual post, let's say I go into this particular post, all right? In that, the complete thing is being seen. That is by, then author name, on, and then the post date, like the date stamp. So I don't want anything over here, not even the by on the home page, which is shown something like this one, all right? So what you can do next is, if you scroll down, it says also read how to remove additional text like by, posted by, etc., which you don't have to read. You'll be figuring it out in this video itself. So next thing which you have to do is you have to just go into a browser which might be like Firefox or Google Chrome. All right, Firefox or Google Chrome, because we would be inspecting a little bit of things for by and on or posted by, something like that. So I'm gonna go into incognito mode right now for Google. You can use Firefox as well, that's fine. And I'm gonna open up my website. All right, so it's loading. And oops, let's close this. And now I'm going to go into individual post. And I'm going to right click on the page and I'm going to click on inspect. Once you click on inspect, it will open up some coding section over here. Don't worry, don't panic. It's plain and simple. Even I don't know coding. What I have learned is a couple of things for inspecting. So once you are opened up with this box, you have to simply click on this thing, which is the first option, which says select an element in the page to inspect it. Or you can, if you are on Mac PC, you can just click on command, then upper arrow and C, like command, upper arrow, C, something like that. But I generally click on this. And then when you move your cursor, it will show you the elements. Right, it will show you individual elements where it is, and respective to that element, you will have all the coding on the right hand side. So you don't have to go into the coding. What you have to simply do is move your cursor when it is something like this. Right, move your cursor when it highlights the entire part, which is the metadata for your posts. All right, so you have to just highlight that. Make sure you highlight the entire thing. Don't just highlight the individual things like author name or post date or this span post date intro or something like that. Make sure you highlight the entire thing, move your cursor accordingly. And whatever you see, you'll see something like div dot by inline dot small. Now that dot by line dot small is not the same for everyone. It depends on the theme, right? So whatever you have after div is something unique for your theme, based on your theme. So for me, it is dot byline dot small. For you, it might be something different, right? So you have to pick that one. So what I'll do is I'll just make note of this thing, dot byline dot small. And now I'll go back into this thing. And what I'll do is I'll just write down byline dot small. Alright, and I'll copy that so that I don't forget that. And I'll come back to my theme and I'll be installing one plugin. Now, depending on your theme, now my theme is already giving me an option to install or copy and paste custom CSS. Now, if it is not available in your theme, you can just install one plugin for advanced CSS. Let's search for that on Google. Advanced. Oops. What's happening? Advanced CSS WordPress. Search for that. You can just install any one of them depending on the ratings. Now both of them are having a top class rating, rating 5. And this is having 1 vote, this is having 3 votes, free. Let's install the first one. Alright, let's open up the first one. So just install this and activate this plugin, and there you go. You will have a specific segment. You'll have a specific segment similar to this one, all right? My theme is having custom CSS. So you'll get a block where you can just copy and paste a couple of extra coding for your entire theme, which will act upon the entire website. You don't have to go into individual pages and do that. You'll have a complete section. So for me, I'm having by default a custom CSS option. If you install that advanced CSS editor, it will show up somewhere over here in the settings box, where it is settings, and you might see something like advanced CSS over here, or at times it might show up on appearance as well. Simply just open up that, and wherever you see the box, copy and paste one thing, which is you have to have your the thing which you copied, that is dot by line dot small. So that is the thing which I copied. And then you have to just have an open bracket like this, hit enter, and you have to paste something like display none important. Now that is the thing which I'll be copying and pasting from here, which is right over here. Display none important. Display none important. Hit enter and close the bracket. Right? Dot byline dot small. Display none important. So that is the thing which you have to write. Now save this custom CSS. And let's try to see whether it's working here or not. Let's refresh the page. So it has gone. All right, it has gone. The date has gone. Now if I go in the home page as well, I'm not able to see anything over here. If I scroll down, nothing over here, right? Nothing over here, nothing over here. If I go into individual post, let's say this particular post, I'm not able to see anything over here. So that's how easy it is to remove your author name, your date, your post by on, whatever you have. All right. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you did, do give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and let me know in the comments what all other methods you have, which might be easier than this, which might help me, other people in the community, and empower other people. All right. So I'll see you in another video. Till then, take care, bye-bye. And as always, guys, hit that thumbs, subscribe, and God bless.